Hey chess lovers, welcome back to the Chessyard. This is Dhairyabagga, and today I'll be playing the 5-minute blitz with 0 seconds increment on Lee Chess. And during the game, I'll try to be as instructive as possible like always, making sure that there's something to be taken away from the game as a learning that helps you improve your game to the next level. Now, before we start off with the game, I request you to subscribe to my channel and press on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of the videos that I'm posting up daily without a miss. So yeah, now quickly let's start off with the game and see how it goes. These are all live recorded. I'm not doing any editing. I'll start off with d4. Play the London system setup. Starts with f4 then, bishop to f4. Pawn to e3. Can't play Jobawa because he has played pawn to c6. So we'll proceed with the normal setup. Knight on f3. Bring that bishop back. If he wants to take, we can take back with the pawn, making sure that we get a good structure as well. Okay, doesn't. Let's drop the bishop to d3. Pawn comes on c3. Can play queen to c2, attacking the pawn. He gets the knight in between. And probably I can just develop my other knight on d2 as well. Just development moves. Okay, he takes, I take back. That is not much well played, I would say. It's inviting troubles for my opponent. I can take now. Spoil his pawn structure too. And probably hop in with the knight in the center. If he doesn't play the pawn forward, which is okay, I can proceed with the other knight. So that if he now takes, things get exchanged up. Okay, he doesn't. Can I just bring my queen over here and then reroute it? That's a long movement of the queen, but that's completely fine. I'm okay doing that. There's no harm. I can castle anytime I want to. The knight is pretty stable there. His knight is not doing much. Probably understands the threat that what I'm trying to do. I still do that because queen can give a check there. Okay. Let's go on with the knight. Two knights now. And the h7 is weakened up. He plays h5 now. Still, I've got two knights. That's a good thing to be done. I still have got some tactic here. Queen goes to h4 and then I give a discover attack to the king. He's attacking my knight. I can take. I can ignore as well. Let's ignore and go ahead with my plan of discover attack next move. Oh, pawn forward can be troublesome, but he doesn't. I can take with the pawn now. Pawn is defending a lot of stuff. Keep knight anywhere and give a check. He understands the threat. Let's play pawn forward. I like this. My knight will be permanent there. He goes back. Let's take the queen backwards now. Job is done. Okay, let's go back. He goes to the side of the board. Can I defend this? I doubt. It's going to come with a check. If I save this, what he does next is going to be nasty. So I have to defend this. Both can't be saved. Can I take his bishop? Nah, not required. Let's save the pawn. he takes. I get my rook away. He gets another pawn in the process. I'll just side move my king there. He gives another check. I move. He gets another pawn at max. Okay, nope. He's trying to move me somewhere else. Okay, let's see. I'm okay moving it upwards as well. There's no threats as such. I can take this bishop anytime I want, if that's a threat. Okay, that's it. That is about it. Let's go ahead with rook over here. And now move my queen as well to probably d1. Okay, he's trying to be cute there. I'll take his bishop first. Don't do these silly tactics. Okay, how is queen more active there? In the center, or let me take the pawn first. Let's see what he's willing to do. Connected pawns in the center. Queen comes up into activity. It's kind of end game now, with pieces still on the board. Yep, he was coming for a check. I can safeguard my king. Nothing to be bothered about. Okay. Let's move the queen. Let's find some good squares for the queen. That attacks the pawn as well. How about I align my pieces? He'll probably play the move. Oh, he doesn't. Okay. That loses the rook. Thank you so much. Yes, you can save it. Okay. I'll come back. Still attacking the pawn. Yep, that had to come. And now rook here. Pawn is being attacked. Just losing out on time, otherwise this winning position. Let's take. Okay. Can come back with my queen. Let's see where the queen goes next. I'm planning to go here. Okay, he saves. And I have to go back. Let's go here. You can still mate him. That's for sure. I think he'll exchange queens now. Seconds versus 1 minute 22 seconds. That's the whole issue now. Otherwise, this is completely winning for white. He doesn't. Is that mate somehow? Can I pull this off? Yeah, that's mate. Phew, I pulled it out on 18 seconds on the clock. I just can't breathe right now. This was so close and I pulled it. It's always very happy feeling when you pull off a tough match. So yeah, let's analyze the game. D4, D5, London system setup, bishop on f4, c6, e3, standard moves, knight to f3, bishop is offered for exchange, I don't take, I bring it back, developing the other pieces, bishop on to d3, he castles, I play c3, and take the bishop whenever I want, so I don't want to do that. Rather align my pieces, so queen to c2, and pin on the knight. I'd get the knight going as well. Takes on the bishop, I take back. As you can see, after it does take, the engine recommends that white is way better now. It was earlier 0.7 before he takes, and after he takes, it becomes 2.2. So, yeah, that's the whole point of bringing your bishop back. So always try that when you're playing the setup. He plays g6 then. I could have just played pawn forward. That forces him to take, maybe. Yes, he does take. I can take with a knight. What's the threat? What is the threat? If knight here, what are we doing? It's just positional advantage. Computer saying we are too strong. Yeah, that you are too ahead in the game just by better positioning of your pieces. And you can castle then. But I took on with the bishop and he takes back. That gives some draw situation. Okay, next time I'll remember that. Knight connecting both the knights so that if he takes, he doesn't take. So I just move my queen. As I was telling in the game plan, that what was my idea behind moving these queen moves. Okay, rook there is also helpful. I didn't do that. He moves away. Why is rook there helpful? Let's quickly check. What's rook doing there? Because if he now moves, what's the follow-up? What does computer want me to do? Give away a pawn. You can take with the pawn. And then leave my knight as well, because there's a discovered attack happening next move. So if he takes, then that's losing his queen. So that's winning. If he, let's go back and see if, sorry, go to the line and see if he doesn't take. He takes with the pawn. I move queen here. And if he moves the king, then what? Then how am I proceeding with the attack? Okay, the other knight. This is what I did in the game, actually. Both the knights were there. And then computer saying he can bring the rook back. And I can castle. Okay. And probably we'll try to just make some queen moves. Or there's nothing that much opponent can do here. That loses the pawn, so he cannot move that. If he moves the queen, how are we proceeding with the attack is my question. Okay, rook here. Knight goes back, say. Rook here. Okay, just creating pressure here. And if knight comes back, then computer saying, okay, take this time. Because if he now takes, oh, you get him with the queen. If he defends with the knight, you take, he takes, you take, and you're too much pressurizing him to take on stuff. This is completely winning. So yeah, could have got some attack there, but rather I went with the other knight straight away. I just played the knight first. It's pawn to h5. I got my queen on h2 with my plan of giving a discovered attack to the king. Go there, he takes on the knight, which was an bad move. Okay, here I took on the pawn first. I should have given him a mat check, and after he moves, then I can take this so that he has to either take or go back. If he takes, that's mate. If he doesn't, he goes back. Then, okay, knight comes in here attacking the rook. He saves his rook, and then we proceed with the attack. So, okay, that was another line which could have been done in the game, but rather I went with first safeguarding my pawn to f4. He comes in, he saves his queen first. I go back, he gets his queen right. Computer is saying castle on the queen side. I don't want to, I just defend. He takes the pawn, I defend my king there, but keep losing some pawns in the process. But that's about it. And then I just try to take control of the situation. Yes, taking this bishop is very important here. I do that. Take on the pawn. he centralizes his king, trying to just make room for his rook. I also get my other rook. He gives a check. I go back. And this was completely okay position, but yes, black has got extra pawns on huge pawns army there, which has to be controlled. And that's what probably I worked towards. And in the process, he just tries to defend the pawn there with a bad move. He should have just played pawn forward. But what was bothering him that point of time was my next move, which can be rook over here as well, that attacks. And if he tries to defend, probably he was thinking I can take on this pawn. But his queen was there guarding it, so there was nothing to be bothered about, except I can definitely proceed with aligning my rooks. That was one plan, but what happens in the game is he loses the rook, and then I'm a piece up. And of course, I'll just try to dominate from there. He plays the move. I just go there. He moves the queen, surprisingly. He didn't have to move the queen there. That was the whole point. And he moves the queen. I take on the pawn, gives the check. I just get my queen for exchange. Even if he exchanges stuff, that would be tough to mate him with two rooks. And he still have got rook on his side. But he rather just doesn't exchange. He wants to keep everything on the board. And that's what led to his misery at the end. I just found ways to align my pieces. And here I thought definitely he'll take. I had done my pre-move as well. I just was wondering that if he now takes, I'll take back. And then probably can push his pawn forward. If he does that, I'll move my rook here. If he tries to defend, I just go here. And then probably some point of time, play rook to d3, take this, and then exchange some stuff. And that would take some time to take these pawns and promote to queen. And I didn't have much time remaining, but rather the opponent sort of just keeping his pieces on the board and play pawn to b3 there. I gave him a check. He goes there. I got the rook. And that's mate in one. And that's what happens. Phew, that was a nice game. I enjoyed it. I hope you liked it. If you did, then do like on the YouTube as well, because there are people that will watch the videos but don't like them, don't comment on them. That makes me a bit demotivated at times, but I'll definitely continue to doing these. But a bit of support from you guys will definitely help me post these with more excitement, with more rich content that helps you improve your game as well. So yeah, please do support my channel. It's a new channel. I want some subscribers as well. So please do subscribe. And thank you so much for your time. Take care. Bye-bye.